GDevelop already includes a powerful built-in 2D collision system that supports collision masks, rotation, and scaling. However, because of its advanced features, it can be quite heavy on performance. For games that need to handle a massive number of collisions at once, such as 2D bullet hell shooters or vampire survivors style games, the built-in collision system may not be ideal. That's where the quick collision detection extension comes in. With this extension, simple collision checks can be processed up to 7 times faster. Let's see how big the difference really is. First, here's what happens with GDevelop standard 2D collision detection. At around 400 by 400 objects, about 160,000 collision checks, the frame rate already drops to around 30 frames per second. When we increase the objects to around 780 by 780, roughly 600,000 collision checks, the frame rate drops below 10 frames per second, making the game nearly unplayable. Now, let's test the quick collision detection extension under the same conditions. With 400 by 400 objects, or 160,000 collision checks, the frame rate stays solid at 60 FPS. Even at 780 by 780, around 600,000 checks, it still maintains 60 FPS. So, how far can we push it? At about 1170 by 1170, roughly 1.3 million checks, the frame rate drops below 60, down to around 40 FPS. At 1550 by 1550, or about 2.4 million collision checks, the frame rate finally dips to around 30 FPS. Still, compared to GDevelop's default collision detection, the frame rate drops much more gradually as the number of objects increases. That's one of the key strengths of the quick collision detection extension. So, how can it handle so many collisions so quickly? The reason is simple. GDevelop's built-in collision detection is feature-rich. It takes into account collision masks, rotation, and scaling, which all require extra calculations. Quick collision detection, on the other hand, ignores those. It only checks simple shapes, rectangles or circles, and it doesn't consider rotation or scale changes. If you need collisions that account for those transformations, you should still use the standard collision system. Quick collision detection is designed purely for simple and high-speed checks. Installing the quick collision detection extension is easy. First, download the extension from the itch.io page. Unzip the file and import quickcollision.json into your game project. You'll then have access to the quick collision behavior and several new conditions. The behavior can be added to any object type, but note that collision shapes are defined around the object's origin point. For that reason, it's best used with sprite objects where you can freely adjust the origin. In this example, let's add the quick collision behavior to a sprite object. In the behavior's properties, set the width and height, or a radius if using a circular shape. Because the shape is defined around the origin, adjust the origin if needed. Prepare another sprite the same way, and set up a collision event between them. The Quick Collision Detection extension provides four types of collision conditions. Each has its own purpose and performance characteristics. Among them, rectangle grid collision is generally the fastest. For this example, we'll use the simplest one, rectangle collision, no range. Create an event so that one object is deleted when a collision occurs. Then, add the draggable object behavior, so you can move the sprite around. Preview the scene, and you'll see it works correctly. However, this small example doesn't really show the power of quick collision yet. Let's add many more objects. Now, enemies appear every frame and move toward the player. Even with a huge number of enemies, collisions are handled smoothly. But actually, this still isn't a challenge for the default collision system. There are about 1,200 enemies and only one player, so that's only around 1,200 collision checks. So, does that mean we just need to increase the number of enemies? It's not that simple. What happens if we increase the number of enemies? Let's spawn 100 enemies every frame and observe the performance, without any collision checks. It may not look obvious at first, but the performance is already dropping heavily. When moving the player, you can see noticeable slowdown even though collisions aren't being checked. There are about 120,000 enemies, and just drawing and updating them already pushes the hardware to its limit. So this test no longer makes sense for collision performance. Instead, let's simulate a more realistic scenario. Many versus many collisions, like in an actual game. For example, 400 bullets and 400 enemies. That's 800 objects total, but around 160,000 collision checks. In this demo, we'll replace the bullets with player objects. Players move outward from the center of the screen, while enemies move toward the center. When they collide, both are deleted. 5 players and 5 enemies spawn every frame. First, let's preview this using GDevelop standard collision system. As the object count increases, the frame rate quickly drops. Now, let's switch to quick collision. There's a bit of slowdown, but the collision performance is clearly much faster. Finally, let's take a look at the fastest one, the rectangle grid collision condition. This time, the number of enemies appearing each frame is doubled to 10. Even under these conditions, it runs so smoothly that you can hardly notice any slowdown. However, please note that the rectangle grid collision condition may not work on some older devices. Choose the condition that best fits your game's design and needs. The quick collision detection extension allows your game to handle many-to-many collisions far faster than ever before. Try adding it to your project and experience the performance difference for yourself.